So nice to wake up naturally. And before you get up and out, stretch. And actually, that feeling, those moments, all the time that you ignore or rush through. Factually, it's one of the most important moments of your day. So don't rush it if you can help it. Between sleeping and waking, and waking and sleeping, there's the possibility of doing more than dreaming, awake or asleep, because that's what we're doing. It's a super conscious moment, minute. It's not measured by seconds. No time exists. As I place my feet together, draw them up to my bum, wide like a frog, like the breaststroke on my back, knees spread wide, pelvis open, head up, straight ahead, spine stretched, shoulders flat, can you feel that? It's my lower back stretching out and relaxing. A lead in bed is one thing. But a good stretch is something else. Been a fairly odd week. There were things that I used to seek, but now I'm just giving everything away, and I have to say that life's flowing more easily. Things are just coming to me. I can let go all the imagined conversations and enjoy social situations. I haven't put my teeth in yet. That's another thing I've been doing ever since I saw my dad's in a glass in the bathroom. I've changed my habits and made sure I clean my teeth every night before sleep. And I don't use none of that fluoride rubbish. Just baking powder. Which is good, because it makes you taste your own breath and teeth. And you're like, really? But at least you know they're getting clean. And it opens up my mind. Polishes that too, till there's a bright sheen. and I'm not writing my dreams down as much as I was. I'm not self-hypnotizing to remember them. I'm just experiencing them as real as though they were this. And quite a lot of them aren't nice. But I know they're not real, even though they feel it at the time. I'm bringing consciousness to bear on them. You might think that it's a crime. It's not. I'm learning so much at night. And I'm facing things so that I'm braver in the day. You can do it too. You just have to realize you can't die whilst you are dreaming. So anything scary or demeaning, like being naked at your workplace, or pissing yourself, or something embarrassing or scary or frightening or terrifying, like being chased by aliens or zombies or a big cat, it's a lesson for you. There's no need to shat your pants. There's no need to be afraid. Deal with it with fun and laughter. Be brave. Accept whatever lesson is there. And you'll find out soon. You spend less time dealing with the past or what happened that day. You won't think about that before you go to sleep. It won't keep you awake in that way. You'll drift right off because you're looking forward to your dream time. And then you won't be dealing with things so much that were in the present, so much as things that are yet to pass. And in your daytime too, you realize, get up. Oh. Naturally so. Don't jump up out of bed because your alarm says so and that you have to get to work. Quit that shit. Don't be a jerk. This is your one life being you, right? At the very least. So shouldn't you enjoy more of these moments? I would think so. Otherwise, what are you playing at? Being so serious, earning money to pay the rent, to drive a car, to a box, an office, some kind of cell, to come back to a cell that's empty all day, that you pay for, with the job you do that you hate or dislike, or at the very least, is not your passion. It's not what you were here for. It's not what you came to this life to do. You know it. You've been there. You've felt it. Not at the weekend when you're pissed or stoned or drugged. Not even on holiday, on that last day when you've just started to relax and heal. And you realize you've got to come back? No, when you're real. When you're looking into the eyes of a friend. Not because you're on a date. Not because you want to get some. Not because you're after borrowing something or